Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. My brothers and sisters, something that's really been eating up at me is the amount of lying and cheating and dishonesty that has become abundant in our community. How many of us, my brothers and sisters, we're lying to the welfare system? We're lying to Centrelink. We're lying in this, you know, family daycare stuff. For what? For what? For a few extra dollars at the end of the week? Sisters are walking into Centrelink with her hijab, kids in the pram, kid on her hand, and she's pregnant, and she's filling out paperwork, signing it, claiming that she's in a de facto relationship. What happened to the quality of a believer? A believer is supposed to be honest. A believer is supposed to be truthful in all of his dealings, in all of his transactions. Indonesia, a whole nation, it embraced Islam. How? Because they seen how the Muslims used to deal in their business, and they knew this was something special. These people are too honest. This was something special, and they embraced Islam. A whole nation. And yet look at the way we deal. Our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was always concerned about his earnings, always concerned that everything he earns is halal, to the point where, imagine, the Prophet of Allah, he's seen his grandson Al-Hassan, and he had a date in his mouth. Imagine, this is a young boy who had a date. The Prophet of Allah, he ran to his grandson and took the date out of his mouth. He said to him, "What are you doing? Don't you know that this is charity? And the family of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he doesn't eat from the charity." Imagine, a date, he was concerned about it. Yet you and I today, no one cares anymore. The Sahaba, imagine, your mothers, our mothers, they used to say to our fathers what? They used to tell them, go out and earn that which is halal. Even if it's something small, we don't mind. Why? They used to say we can be patient on being hungry, but we cannot be patient on the hellfire. No one cares anymore. Lying. You're signing paperwork claiming that you're doing something, and you're not, and you're earning money. And what you're not realizing, my brothers, you know, just because everyone around you does it, that doesn't make it okay. This money that you're earning, wallahi, even if it's $1, this dollar is haram. It's haram, and everything that you do with this $1 is haram. So you could be eating halal, yani food that's slaughtered Islamically, and you said Bismillah, but you bought this food with that dollar that is haram. Then this food has become haram. Your drink has become haram. You're living in a house and you're paying your rent, and you're paying it with money that you've earned from Centrelink through lying about your condition and your status. Then your living in this house has become haram. People always complain to me, and they tell me, brother, you know, I make dua and I don't feel connection. You know, I pray and I'm not feeling anything, you know. Why? Because of this. Because of this, this is playing a massive role. The Prophet of Allah used to always warn his companions, be sure that everything you eat and everything you earn is halal. Why? Because it has a direct effect with our connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And finally, you know, for those people who want to claim to me that, oh brother, look, you know, we're living in a, you know, that we're living in a non-Muslim country and we're in a state of war, so therefore we're allowed to cheat and lie. Where do you get this from? And then when we look at our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, look at the way he was. When he was in a real state of war, when the people of Mecca were after him and they had a bounty on his head and they were going after him to kill him and have his head, and the Prophet of Allah, he left Mecca to go to Medina, what did he do? This was a man whom even the non-Muslims, they used to testify and say that he was what? As-Sadiq al-Amin. And they used to leave their belongings and they used to leave that which was valuable with him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So when he left Mecca for Medina and he had their belongings, what did he do? He left his cousin Ali bin Abi Talib radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He said, Ali, you stay behind and you give these non-Muslims, you give back to them which belongs to them. Why? If that was you and I, who cares, brother? Rip them. Take their stuff and run. No, this is not Islam. The Prophet of Allah, he left Ali back to give back to the people which belongs to them, because as a Muslim, we don't take anything that doesn't belong to us, even if it's something minute. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those people who only earn that which is halal, and to put barakah in our living and in our eating. And until next time, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.